A single day can change everything. One fall day in 1940, we knew Britain was impregnable, protected by the sea, and defended by brave souls on every clifftop. 24 hours later, all we could do was watch as the German forces took the coast and drove their tanks into the heart of the nation. When the blockade began in 1948, we thought the people of West Berlin would be safe. But the Soviets had other ideas. One December day is all it took for the fragile peace to shatter. And once again, the streets were filled with war and death. In 1962, we thought the Cuban Missile Crisis was a bluff. It was bravado. Playground bullies flexing their muscles. No one would ever push the button. Then, one day in October that year, someone did push it. An island paradise was turned into the epicenter of all-out thermonuclear war, threatening our very existence. These are our stories. Now, it's your turn. Not every American tank built was destined for the U.S. Army. Some were transported through the Persian corridor into Russia. From the steelworks of Detroit, straight to the Eastern Front. And it wasn't just tanks that wound up in Russia. The Americans sent experienced combatants, too. Colonel Peters had joined the Russian advance into Romania. With the news spreading that a second front had opened up in France, both sides knew this was a critical turning point in the war. Position on the hill, Peters and his Russian crew were about to get their first taste of action as a joint force. The Germans had launched a preemptive strike on the Russian armor. Peters knew if he didn't keep his Sherman moving, he'd end up a burning wreck. With the German tanks routed, Peters looked at his Sherman crew with pride. They had passed their first test admirably. The German preemptive strike had been fierce, the Soviet losses heavy. Regardless, the orders still stood. The Russian offensive would continue as planned. Colonel Peters suddenly found himself caught up with the push towards the enemy front line. The Russian Shermans had managed to stem the German onslaught, but they lacked the necessary reinforcements to press home their advantage. One thing was clear to Peters: they needed more tanks. It was now a race against time for the Russians. They could make for the disabled tank and turn it against their enemy, or engage the German patrol directly with the remaining Shermans. Peters prayed they would make the right call. Peters rallied his crew. It was their turn to strike back at the Germans. He'd capture some abandoned tanks and turn them against the enemy. Shermans were lost. The Germans had won this encounter. Peters nor his crew would ever live to see out the end of the war.